Hello, everybody. I'm Dare Tepper. This is your Farming Simulator 15 mod spotlight. We have something I thought was more than what it was. The picture on the link made me think it was a lot more than what it was, and I got in the game, and when I get in, I just check and make sure that they're physically there, and I was like, wow, that's it? So let's look at what that was. Where do I need to go? Eeny, meeny, miny. Let's go sprayers. A Montag 1700. The picture actually shows it attached to a huge sower, and I thought it was a sower and fertilizer dual thing, but it's apparently just a sprayer, so we're going to play with it and see what happens. 32,000 to buy, 30 day to own, 5,600 liter capacity, 16 meters of working width. So 32,000 and 5,600. So let's buy it. So 32,000 and 16 meters, 5,600. All right, so we're going to go look at the in-game sprayer. More capacity. And a little bit less of a width and cheaper in-game. In-game one is cheaper, lower capacity, bigger working width. If we could look at fertilizer spreader, way cheaper, better. It's closer to the ZG-B8200, really, I guess. I mean, kind of your thoughts there. That's not all we got. We also have in cars, we have a John Deere service truck, 45,000 to buy, 45 a day to own, 375 horsepower. Key N and M to make it look like it's being used to repair a vehicle or a vehicle. Whatever, buy it. And then we have a Chevy Silverado, which they took the screenshot in the Blender. Really? All right. Cool. 35,000 to buy. One a day to own. Wow. This will be fun. Let's put it in Chevy-ish blue, I guess. That's not all I have. I also have a placeable. It is a stationary cutter. 250,000. Wow, that's expensive. $250,000 to buy it. 50 a day to own it. It is a placeable wood chipper. So we're going to place it somewhere near a piece of wood. Let's go. Just one piece of wood. Where is my farm? Wow, what's that thing? Oh, that's that. Okay. Where in the world is my farm? Be cool if they actually had a map so that you might be able to see where in the world you are. Ah, here we go. There's the farm. That's the corn. So all of that should be cuttable. We'll put it right, how about right there? Because I'll be sure to crash into it. It does require diesel fuel to operate. So we're going to have to go back into here, into our misc, and we're going to have to get our diesel fuel tanker. This only carries 4,500. It's an 8,000 liter capacity on that thing, but it's all right. We'll just do that. And then we're going to need some forestry equipment probably to haul it. Let's not go with that. Can we get a good log fork? Yeah, let's get the log fork, and we'll get a... But I don't want one of those. Oh, we got the log fork, and we've got the this guy right here, the JCB. We're going to use the JCB. Okay, let's check out the equipment that we have bought-eth. We've got our Montag here. Looks good. Can't really walk through it. I mean, you can walk through those row crop wheels, but that's fine. You can climb on top of it. That's always nice. Here is our 450. 350. Never mind. I thought it was 450. No, it's 3. Okay, nothing runs like a deer. You can't clip into anything. Doesn't look like we got a hitch there. That's actually a good thing. You're parked right on top of the Chevy. You can walk on top of the Chevy. That's a good sign. Okay, Chevy's got... Okay, we're going to have to test the gooseneck of the Chevy. All right, things are looking good. Things look good. Let's start with the Chevy. Did I get in the right truck? I did get in the right truck. Okay, refuel. What would I refuel? Oh, I bet you I'm refueling from that John Deere. Okay, so Z, lower Silverado.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Ah, I can go to a stance show now. Oh, we just need to get the, we got to get the wheel camber set. We can go to a stance show. That's awesome. All right, so there's our Silverado. It has 83 kilometers an hour, which honestly is actually a pretty decent number for Farm Sim. I love it. It's just like airbags. That is awesome. Oh my goodness, that is hilarious. All right, so the interior, actually the interior is pretty good. I mean, the finish, not so much, but the interior doesn't look terrible. The mirrors don't work for anything, but hey, whatever. All right, I need to get this guy out of the way. I don't know why I keep putting this guy in front. I barely keep putting him in front just so that he's in my way, but there you go. All right. The Silverado, I can't speak. Oh my goodness, look at my dude. Oh my goodness, oh my good grief, what has happened to him? Oh my goodness, he has had a run-in with some sort of alien technology. Oh, that is creepy. There's so much wrong with that. So much wrong with that. Oh goodness. All right, let's all right, we got it attached. Okay. Hello, truck. You're already pointing for the moon. Okay, I can see this is going to be a serious problem, honestly. Let's see. Let's open up the back door. All right. So I bet if I put this Dodge in the back here, that we're going to have an issue where that Silverado is going to have trouble. Okay, there. Yeah, that's good enough. Maybe not. Maybe so. Oh, come on. Come on, Chevy. You can do it. Oh, God, that's terrible. Like, it's a dually. I'm sorry. You can put several tons of weight on a dually before it starts to squat. But on the bright side, we can select the Chevy. Ding! Now we can go to the stand show. Oh, we have a floating trailer. But we can go to the stand shows now, so that's a thing, right? Everybody wants to go to those. If you don't know what a stand show is, count yourself lucky, I guess. All right, let's free the Dodge from the trailer and free the Chevy from being involved. All right, I mean, it'll do its job, but I don't know. Quiet. All right, let's check out the Ford now. Jeez. All right, interior of the Ford. Mirrors don't work for crap. That's becoming pretty much standard. All right. Okay, it's okay. I'm okay with that. All right, so we're at, we had 79 kilometers an hour. That's also a decent enough speed. We have beacons. Beacons are important. Okay, so M is to repair a tire. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's a lot of little details right there. That's tire repair. All right. And N is repair the engine. That's pretty cool. Yeah, that's not bad. I can do both. I can do all the things. Hold on. Can I leave the beacons on while I'm out? No. Aw. They're sort of stuck on. That's a lot of, like, high detail JPEGs right there. Pretty good. I mean, it's the little things, right? Look at all those tools. I have to imagine that they're secured a little bit differently in a real service truck, but... All right. Let's make sure we can't have a... Oh, wait. Can I? No. I was just checking if the crane worked, because I was going to be like, oh! If the crane worked, it would be amazing, because then you could technically use this as a logging truck, which would be awesome. All right. Let's see here.
Wow.
Wow. Wow. Wow. Again, with the poorly done design thought here of let's leave the attach hitch in, but let's put something on the back. Really, guys? Really? Is that necessary? Jeez. So a decent truck, but it does have that attach point, which is kind of annoying. Okay. Apparently it has the ability to refuel itself. So, yeah, apparently it does. So we're going to take a quick run up to the, what is that thing? The placeable. Because if this thing is a infinite fueling point that I get charged for anyway, I might as well go up there and just have it refuel it. Because why not? Then I don't need the trailer. All right, here we are. Let's see here. Can we... Oh, it looks like I can only fill... Can I only refill myself? Yeah, that seems to be the thing. Okie dokie, then. Not as useful as I thought. So you have to be in a separate vehicle. Okay, well, I mean, I can understand that. That's cool. That's cool. All right, so we'll run the Silverado up there, then. And I will fuel that, and then we'll actually... Let's just reset the other equipment, shall we? Not that thing. You. And... That. We'll get a tractor there at the farm to deal with that. And... That. That should be everybody. Yes. All right. All right, we're going to refill the trailer here. Well, that does that. I need to find the scorpion. Let's see. Let's actually go this way. Aha! I found the scorpion. All right. Where is his? There it is. All right. Let's go and see about cutting down some trees. This is a scorpion, right? I'm going to call it a scorpion whether it is or not, because it makes me think of a scorpion, because that's the tail. I know, scorpions don't hiss. Leave me alone. All right, let's see. Did you finish refueling? Yes, okay. Come on, Silverado, you can do this. Okay. Ooh, is this one of those where it requires very specific... No. Okay. You are in the way now, my weird friend. All right. That's better. Interesting. So there's really... okay, I see. I think you need the... It didn't say that I needed a special trailer, but we might need a special trailer. Let's buy a chainsaw, because that would be a good idea. Thank you. Let's cut down a tree. Let's not cut down those trees. I hate those trees. This tree, because it's in the way. That sounds like a good plan. Okay, we're going to make it fall on the Chevy. Well, and the Scorpion. Oh, good lord. Okay. Woo! We escaped the tree attack. All right, let's see if we can grab a piece of the tree here. Do I actually have? No. What's going on? I need you to... What do I need you to do? I need you to... There, maybe.
No.
Okay. All right. This is good. It's good. It's good. Why am I getting this confused? Why am I having so much trouble today? Okay. There we go. Now. Oh, because the controls are backwards. That's what the problem is. There. I'm used to the controls of the New Holland, but this one's controls are backwards. It's... In. Go in. Ah, okay. If I walk up here, so I don't have any fuel, right. Fuel empty, I know, but how do I refuel it then? If I'm right here, okay, that makes me think. So, that's fuel, but you're not gonna work because you don't wanna connect to that, probably because it's gonna require one of those special trailers that I don't have loaded. Cool. Well, I guess I'm going to go load that trailer. All right. So while I'm fixing one thing, let's see if this, how this will work. So we got ourselves our Montauk. I'm refilling a coat universal thingamajiggy. As you can see by my money going down like crazy. All right. So let's refill the sprayer. Wow. 17 frames to second. Something is going on over there. That's killing my frame rate. That's something I get to figure out sometime. Probably all the crappy mods that I have. Be my guess. Alright, that's enough. Okay. So, we've got this thing. The picture showed it attached to a cedar, but we don't have the cedar, so we're just gonna have to operate without the cedar right now. That's fine. We'll go spray some crop and see what it looks like. So let's go right over here and turn this guy on. And wow, it just sprays from. I have no idea where it's spraying from. Interesting. It's just like the magic spray. But still, I mean, it's doing exactly as offered. It's spraying. It's not inexpensive, which is probably its downfall, but if you're looking for something like this, there you go. If you can find the cedar that it's shown with on the picture, it probably would do great with that. Though I think that cedar was way more than a 17-meter cedar, so... you know, whatever, I guess. But there you go. It's a Montauk. Montauk? Montauk. That's what we're going to go with. Montauk. Cool. All right. Are we done over here? I hope we're done over here. Now, according to my money, we're not done over here, but I think we are done because, you know, reasons. All right. Okay, so it's an 8,000 liter tank on this thing over here anyway, so we have more than 8,000 liters in here. So now we just need to figure out how to fill this thing. Where do I position my trailer to fill my fuel tank? Is it positioned over here? I think that's where it would be. No. Okay, I'm confused why this would be so difficult. All right, fine, truck. I don't care. Um, You think they would have made the trigger point large enough? No. Okay, did I miss something on, like, over here that I could press a button? No. No, it just doesn't want to work. Well, there you go. That kind of saddens me, quite honestly. And the idea is great. The execution. I can't get fuel into it. If you make a mod like that, you kind of have to tell us how to fuel it up. I mean, seriously. The Chevy, you can figure it out. It's a great truck if you're going to a stance competition. The Ford down there, it's got some great kit with it. Its usefulness is sort of limited, but it is a mobile fuel post, which is okay. I don't like it has a fifth wheel hitch on it. That's kind of annoying. And then the Montag all the way down at the end there, that works, but it is expensive. Still, all the links to all the mods is in the description. That's what I'm trying to say. I've been Derek Tubbers. This has been your Farming Simulator 15 Mod Spotlight. Until next time, as always, game on and be awesome, everybody.